2.5 weeks away now from the midterm elections, and Senator Bernie Sanders is stepping up his ground game for Democrats. He announced a 9-day campaign blitz, including stops in several states that are crucial for securing Democratic congressional seats. Sanders was in Bloomington, Indiana yesterday, urging people to get out to vote for Liz Watson, who is challenging Congressman Trey Hollingsworth in the state's 9th district.
I have zero doubt that if instead of 28% of the people voting in Indiana, 50%, and that's not a heavy lift, 50% of the people come out and vote, this is your next congressperson.
Meanwhile, Sanders is on the ballot himself this year, trying to win a third term as a senator in Vermont. Does this last-ditch effort pay off at the polls? Well, here with me to discuss is Liz Watson. Got it wrong going into the break, but Liz Watson, good to have you with us, Democratic congressional candidate for Indiana's 9th District. Thanks for being with us this morning.
Thanks so much for having me on.
All right, so let's start here with just the numbers here. Of course, you're running in a red state. President Trump in 2016 won Indiana by 19 points. He won the ninth district there by 26 points. So why is Democratic Socialist Bernie Sanders the right voice to help you get across the line in a red state that President Trump took by such a large margin?
Look, I've campaigned across this district in all 13 counties with a whole lot of Hoosiers and Congressman Lee Hamilton, Congressman Barron Hill, the Democrats who held this seat for a very long time. Senator Sanders agrees with some very basic concepts that I think Hoosiers agree on, that when people get sick, they should have a fighting chance to get better, that instead of passing tax cuts for the 1%, we should be investing in making education affordable in our infrastructure. We should be keeping Medicare and Social Security for this generation and the next. We shouldn't be breaking our promises. Those are things that we all agree on. Those are Hoosier values. And I'm glad that Senator Sanders came to shine a light on the great work that we're doing in this district to get Hoosiers real representation we can count on.
Well, if you ask another Hoosier who is running for re-election, Joe Donnelly, statewide for the Senate, he would disagree with many of the things that you're espousing and that Senator Sanders agrees with. Let's watch a portion of one of his recent campaign ads, and then we'll talk.
Socialists want to turn health care over to the government.
Over my dead body, not on my watch.
The radical left wants to eliminate ICE.
I support ICE, funding President Trump's border wall.
Okay, so he's trying to create as much different distance between himself and Medicare for All, which I know you support and Senator Sanders supports. How do you pay for it?
Look, we have so much partisan divide in this country, and we know that we have different ways of getting to the solution, but we need to get there. What we've seen about Medicare for All, and this was by a Koch brothers funded study, is that overall it would reduce health care costs by about $2 trillion because it reduces administrative costs, because we would be able to cover every single one of us. And we're not even talking about the opportunity cost of leaving people on
but
the sidelines.
Liz,
of the
if you're
economy.
Quoting, if you're going to quote the Koch brothers funded study, and I know the one you're talking about, that also says it's going to cost $32 trillion. If
which
that's
is
the
actually
study you're going
less.
With.
Which is less than we're currently spending as a nation on health care. So it talks about a reduction in costs. And, you know, I think we can walk and chew gum on this one, right? So Trey Hollingsworth voted to take health care away from 400,000 Hoosiers and millions of Americans. I talked to a woman just last week who cried through tears telling me about how her mother was not diagnosed until she had stage 4 cancer because she didn't have health insurance. She didn't have the health care she needed to get a diagnosis, and shortly after her diagnosis she died. She doesn't have her mother because her mom didn't have health care. Trey Hollingsworth doesn't care about her mom and doesn't care about her. He wants to take us back to the days when a pre-existing condition was a death sentence. He voted to do that, and that's not okay.
All right, I've got two quick yes or no's. Hopefully you can give me just the yes or no's. I know it's a difficult place to be in, but I've got them for you. Should House Democrats move to impeach the president if they get control and you are a member of the House?
Look, I'm focused on the issues in my district. No, I don't think that impeachment is a good move for the country.
Okay.
I think that we need to get to actually governing and less grandstanding.
Thank you. And very quickly, if you win as a part of a Democratic recapture control of the House, can Nancy Pelosi count on your vote for Speaker?
I've already addressed this issue. I'm not voting for Nancy Pelosi. I think we need new leadership in Washington.
All right, Liz Watson there in Indiana's 9th. Thank you so much.
Thank you.